I do lots of proteomics, and I try to isolate lots of transient complexes, and I find that Dynabeads were perfect in capturing these transient interactions, and it also eliminates problem of background which we had with Sepharos. So I'm gonna be continue using Dynabeads in my future research as long as it needed, because we like it very much.